We want to find an equation of a quadratic function that has zeros, negative 3 and positive 4. Before we do this, let's start with a quick review. The zeros or roots of a quadratic function are the x values for which f of x is equal to 0. So if we're given the zeros, it tells us something about the factored form of the quadratic function. So for example, if the zeros or roots are r sub 1 and r sub 2, then a possible quadratic function would be f of x equals some constant a times a factor of x minus r sub 1, where r sub 1 is one of the zeros, times a factor of x minus r sub 2, where r sub 2 is a 0. Notice by subbing in r sub 1, this factor would be 0, therefore the function value would be 0. And if we sub r sub 2 into the second factor, this factor would be 0, giving us a function value of 0 as well. And one last comment, that if our zeros are real, then if we graph the quadratic function, the x-intercepts would also be the zeros of the function. So going back to our example, if our zeros are negative 3 and positive 4, one possible quadratic function would have to have a factor of x minus the 0 of negative 3, and would have to have a second factor of x minus positive 4. Now we could also place any constant here, but normally we just let a equal 1 so we can leave it off. But let's go ahead and simplify this first factor. We would have f of x equals the quantity x plus 3, remember subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive, times the factor of x minus 4. Now let's pause here just for a moment. Notice how if the 0 is negative 3, the factor is x plus 3, and if the 0 is positive 4, the factor is x minus 4. So you can think of these constants here being the opposite of the given zeros. Now we'll go ahead and multiply this out and have a possible quadratic function with the given zeros. Remember, we'll have four products here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll have f of x equals x squared minus 4x plus 3x minus 12. Go ahead and combine our like terms here. So we have f of x equals x squared. Negative 4x plus 3x is negative x, so we'll have minus x minus 12. This would be a possible quadratic function with the given zeros. In this case, the leading coefficient would be equal to 1. I do want to make one more quick comment about what would happen if we did place a constant here in the front. Let's just say, for example, we let the constant equal 3. Another possible quadratic function would be f of x equals 3 times our two known factors of x plus 3 and x minus 4. To multiply this out, we would start by multiplying the two binomial factors. So we'd have 3 times the quantity x squared minus x minus 12. And now we would distribute the 3. So another possible quadratic function with the same zeros would be f of x equals 3x squared minus 3x minus 36. I wanted to mention this because we can't just put a constant here in front of the x squared. It would have to be a constant in front of the two binomial factors. And to finish, since our zeros are real, we can graph this function to make sure that our x-intercepts are negative 3 and positive 4. So here's the graph of our function. Notice how the zeros are here at x equals negative 3 and here at x equals positive 4. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. Next, we'll take a look at how we do this when the zeros are fractions.